nothing engenders fear and horror among Australians like a summer holocaust. Wildfires like this can bring down in minutes what has taken a lifetime to build. Fire, though, is a natural part of the Australian environment. It's been as regular as summer itself for thousands of years. In fact, fire has been such a dominant factor that many native plants are adapted to periodic burning. But fire out of control is no respecter of man or beast. It's not surprising that so much effort in manpower and equipment is applied to suppressing fire in Australia. But this destructive power of bushfires, properly controlled, could be worth a lot of money to hundreds of graziers. Working in semi-arid woodlands of eastern Australia, scientists from CSIRO's Division of Land Resources Management have found that the suppression of fire is not always for the best. When the pioneers pushed inland from the coast with their sheep and cattle, they found vast open and grassy woodlands with abundant feed for their animals. But gradually, and then dramatically, the landscape began changing. So much so that today, a vast area of some 400,000 square kilometres extending from central New South Wales into central Queensland is being choked by a dense sea of invading shrubs. The CSIRO scientists believe the reason for the change is partly due to overgrazing by sheep and rabbits, which have removed the grasses and given the shrubs the competitive edge, and, ironically, the efforts of settlers. CSIRO rangeland ecologist Dr. Graham Harrington.
We know that fire will kill many of these problem shrubs, and we also know that since Europeans arrived in this country about 100 years ago, the frequency of bushfires has been greatly reduced, and this coincides with the growth, this vast increase in growth of shrubs that we see here today.
The invading shrub is literally forcing sheep off the land, as grazier George Lucas knows only too well. When he bought his property, Clifton Downs, at Yantabulla in the far north of New South Wales in the early 1960s, he could muster this paddock alone in a matter of hours. Now, with a dense cover of shrub, it takes three men twice as long. And even then, they can never be sure of a complete muster. The ability of his property to support livestock has been reduced by 50% in recent years, and his chances of finding sick or injured sheep are almost nil. The CSIRO research team believes the shrub will survive the next drought, but the grasses won't, which means that when the drought breaks, the grasses will not re-establish. And not only the sheep suffer, the shrubs are depriving the red kangaroo of its natural habitat and creating a haven for feral animals like pigs and goats. In an effort to push back the shrub and restore the natural balance, Dr. Harrington and his team are carefully reintroducing fire into the woodlands. But is fire foreign to this environment?
Well, no, fire is a natural part of this environment, but either lightning fires or Aboriginal started fires. And knowing this, and knowing that it was open country before Europeans got, or when Europeans got here, we've been carefully reintroducing fire into this system. And as you can see here, it's very effective. These shrubs are dead.
Years of experience in studying bushfire behaviour go into ensuring the scientists have a controlled, not a wild fire. But given the traditional Australian attitude towards fire, is there a better way of bringing paddocks back to productive operations?
Well, we've looked at all the possible alternatives, herbicides, mechanical clearing, goats, and they've either proved ineffective or they proved far too expensive to have any hope on this large scale of controlling this scrub.
Burning often causes seeds of shrubs to germinate. Therefore, a second fire is necessary to kill off these seedlings. The management of paddocks after the fire is also important to the success of the technique. Animals favour burnt country, and the graziers need to be careful not to allow rejuvenated vegetation to be overgrazed. So, an important part of the continuing research is the study of the migratory habits of kangaroos and goats into burnt areas. Just how strong a chance does the CSIRO experiment have of solving the shrub problem?
Well, our research program has got quite a few points to follow up yet as to how fire can be incorporated into property management. But what I am absolutely sure of is that there is no alternative to fire to stop this country from thickening up so that it will be no longer productive as far as sheep are concerned.